I have a package.
Oh, hi.
I ordered something, like I pre-ordered something a while back, like months ago. So, you know, just to be safe, I had them send it to my permanent address. So they're like, hey, you know, you got a couple of packages here. I'm like, a couple? I only ordered one. It should be a couple of things that I was expecting. But I pre-ordered two things from one place. So I figured it would be, you know, both in one package. About a box, maybe a little bit smaller than this. And I got two packages. And I'll tell you one thing. This is definitely one of the things that I ordered. This definitely is not. I have no idea what this is. It's 4.5 pounds. And it's from Amazon. I know what this is. This is not from Amazon. And it's probably like 4.5 ounces. But this is a mystery to me. So when it comes to this unboxing, I'll be on the edge of my seat. I have no idea what's in it. I'm like, is it a gift? Maybe someone ordered a gift for me and they were like, whoops, wasn't supposed to put your name on it. I doubt that. So, this, however, I'm very excited about. We have the brand new album from KoRn. But this is not just any album, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, it's a little smaller than what we're all familiar with today, these things called records that I was familiar with as a kid, of being the old way of listening to music that my parents might have had a few of. But boy, has it made a resurgence, and that seems to be the main way people like to listen to their music these days, albeit digital still being number one. This is not a CD. I know I was talking about record, but it's neither. It's not round at all. My dad mentioned, yes, they should make an 8-track, but this album is currently available on record, CD, and cassette tape. I mean, come on. Come on! It's a freaking cassette tape. Well, oh, look at that. They were selling exclusive ones at, like, you know, your independent records and whatnot of these, but the tape is red. I was like, oh, man. But I don't have, you know, I don't have a car, and there's no independent right down the street, so I just ordered this one. But honestly, I'm pretty thrilled that I did, because this is like platinum silver hematite, you know what I mean? Look at that. What? That's gorgeous! Oh, that is beautiful. It almost makes me want to not open it. 2022, the KoRn partnership under exclusive license. Mm-hmm. Okay. Ah. Yes. Even better. Made in Canada. Just like me. So, yes. Cassette tape. Now, obviously, I own the album on CD. I went to Best Buy when it came out, and I was like, I don't know, roaming around. I went there a couple years ago looking for a CD, and they had, you know, they were down to like the one rack of just new releases. But I'm like, I couldn't find them anywhere. I'm like, hey, where's your CDs? They looked at me and were like, take a hike, old man. What are these CDs you speak of? Yeah, so they don't sell those anymore. Luckily, I found a Barnes & Noble right down the street. And they still had their big music section. So I was like, whew, sweet. It was mostly full of records. And I get it. I get the record thing. I actually recently purchased a record because it was an exclusive limited edition Tron record. It's all blue. Comes with exclusive songs from the soundtrack never before released. Anyway, I should get one of them record players. But luckily they had a few CDs at Barnes & Noble, and they had one left, so I snagged it on CD, and obviously the moment it dropped, I'd been listening to it nonstop on streaming. I wanted a cassette tape. It took me back. The last cassette tape I bought was Untouchables by KoRn, which was their fifth album. So that was what, like 2002? Something like that? 2001? Early 2000s. So I haven't bought a tape in like 20 years. And here I am buying KoRn's newest and 14th album. Untouchables was their fifth. Huh. 9 albums later, I bought another tape. So that's cool. But the other thing I ordered was from them as well. Whenever I can get something that's the cover, like when they came out with the Ragdoll, you could get it like Hot Topic for the cover of Issues. Oh, I got me one of those.
Oh, here's some more, actually. Anyway.
As you can see, there's a lot of random things around here.
I think it's right over there, actually.
Wait, regardless. We should open this. I almost don't want to, but... I would also like to listen to it. Because I was like, why get this? Well, kind of like a gimmicky thing. I want my last tape to be this album after going so long. Kind of like just because I could. Why not? Cassette tape. How nostalgic. Nostalgia is the big drug that's in right now. Nostalgia is one hell of a drug. Because it makes you feel young. And then makes you feel immortal. It makes you feel like you can live forever. Ah, yes. It's like, nostalgia is like drinking from the fountain of youth. It takes you back in time to rejuvenate you and make you feel young again, which then makes you in turn subconsciously feel like you can live longer and live forever, yada, yada, yada. So nostalgia is a hell of a drug. There's a reason why we love it. It's not just like, oh, that makes me think of pretty fun memories. More to it than that. Oh, blinding me. It's so beautiful. Oh, and I love a cassette tape case. Come on now. Brand new cassette tape case. Look at that beauty. Look at that beauty. Oh my goodness. For the record, I highly recommend this album if you're a fan of music. But especially rock music. And if you're a fan of KoRn, then yeah. Yeah. Oh, we got the little thing here. Hold on here. Little insert. Then you could take these out, and sometimes you could unfold them, like, really long, and they would have all the lyrics. Jonathan, of course, never has his lyrics. Okay, cool. Just like, oh, see, look at that. Just like the CD. You know what's not in the CD? I don't know if it's in the record. I can't vouch for that. But it's definitely not in the CD. This picture here. Look at those fine young gentlemen. All right. So there we go. KoRn Requiem cassette tape. But what am I going to do with it? I'm going to play it. Huh. Sesame Street. People in Your Neighborhood. Classic. 1980. Grew up on this tape. Still have it. Yeah, I said 1980. Dating myself. Side A. Because there's two sides, and then you had to flip it over. It's like a VHS tape, only instead of rewinding, you turn it over. Oh man, this thing's glorious. I hope it doesn't ding or scratch or anything being played. That thing's beautiful. Huh? Shall we?
And away we go.
Yeah, it works. Good time. But this particular tape player, the last tape player I've ever had, and I've had it for a very long time, at least 20, maybe 25 years. To put it in perspective, I used to listen to the original Mortal Kombat soundtrack on this thing, nonstop. I have a very vivid memory of watching the Oscars and or Emmys, and each commercial break, I ran upstairs to listen to Mortal Kombat! Do, 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 do. song playing of that, commercial break was over. It was great. I was hooked on that song. Anyway, this particular one has an alarm. Not just a radio. Not just an alarm. Beep, beep, beep. But you can set a cassette tape to alarm. You press play, it locks it into place. When it clicks to the time, boom, your tape starts playing right where you left it. So that's my new alarm. Anyway, I'm very excited about owning this cassette tape of KoRn Requiem. Great album, great band. I met them once. But that's another story. I should tell a story about all the bands I've seen and all the celebrities I've met. Because they would have to be multiple and separate videos. I'm a very fortunate man. I've been to dozens and dozens of concerts, seen some pretty amazing artists that I'm very thankful for. And I've met some pretty awesome celebrities, and so far, none of them have really disappointed. I'm very fortunate, and I'm very thankful for it. I don't take it for granted. For the record, yes, Jonathan Davis has saved my life. Many a times. So now, it's time to see what's in this mystery box. Okie dokie.